So in my journey of becoming a doctor, I've had many friends, and I'm continuing to make friends. And in that journey, so many people have been suffering sadly with depression, anxiety, and panic attacks. And it's a taboo even in medical field, and it is so sad. So people who are preparing for their PG exam, NEET exams, USMLE, I've heard many experiences when they talk about how they get shivers or palpitations before the exams. You have to diagnose yourself first so that you can go to a healthcare professional. Because, you know, there is a lot of resistance before visiting a psychiatrist or a psychologist in that matter. But I just want to say, it's pretty common. And you just deal with it like you deal with asthma, like you deal with gastritis. Because these are the things that MBBS sadly gave to me. Yes, during my MBBS, I developed allergic bronchitis. And every time when I had stress, I used to have those breathlessness attacks. And in my residency, I developed gastritis, again, thanks to the stress. Whenever I had exams or any presentation, I used to have severe cramping of gastritis. So I dealt with it. I visited a gastroenterologist. I consulted the doctor that needed to see the condition and, you know, prescribe something, because I wanted it to not become the mountain in front of the goal that I was wanting to achieve. So if you want to achieve a goal and there is an anxiety, depression, panic disorder or whatnot between your goal and you, will you just carry it with you or will you deal with it first? Because if you carry it with you, the journey is going to become so much harder. And trust me, I have had seen many people who just suffer the trauma, who just suffer the pain, just because they are not, I don't know, brave enough, or there is too much of taboo, or there is too much of resistance. So for all of those, for all of you, you can become successful with these diseases. They are just like any other disease. You don't make them big by hiding them or by not talking about them or not treating them. Please. Because sometimes exam stress can be a real thing. And sometimes you can have a temporary, you know, panic attacks. So consider talking to your friends about it, talking to your family about it. And if you think your daily life is getting hampered because of these diseases or because of those symptoms, you're adult enough to know what are the symptoms, right? Like, you cannot carry out your daily life. You feel numb. You feel helpless. You feel hopeless. You feel worthless. These were the symptoms that we were taught when you know, we were studying in MBBS. So these are the basic symptoms. Go on Google and search of the symptoms and see if you fall into that criteria. Because if you can treat it now, then it will be so easy. The journey will be so easy. You don't have to stop the journey. You don't have to carry it along. You just have to consider treating it and then becoming a stronger version of yourself and then taking on the journey. This is something I really wanted to say, because I feel really bad when people just carry with their struggles and don't take help. So please, please guys, take care. Take care. The journey is long, especially for the medical students. The journey is never ending. The padhai will never end. Literally, I have finished my residency in India and I'm still in the journey of studying for USMLE. So if you're mental power is not strong enough, you will fall behind. So you have to keep it under control. with whatsoever techniques possible and take help, okay? See you.